Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for August 25th, 2020. Well, yesterday we had the bulls out in force. They were really pushing hard and strong, and we had a little bit of a pop and drop first thing in the morning. We popped up and then pulled back, and then in came those bulls with lots of strength on the day, pushing us up substantially. And we are looking at, right over here was that morning, sorry. There was that morning pullback, and then the bulls came in strength and just continue to push to the upside. So the diamonds looking very, very bullish here, holding a strong upside trend, holding support levels cleanly. Nice little setup here for more upside in this market. And this morning, we are looking at bulls driving into that Dow index with some changes coming at the end of the month. So what does that mean for today? Well, how about we saddle up, let's grab ourselves something to drink, and let's get ready for the Tuesday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. So this morning we have kind of an interesting situation. We've got a few more news events to deal with here today, and earnings and on the economic calendar. But so far this morning we have futures showing lots of bullishness here in the Dow. There was news yesterday that there is a big change coming to the FOMC, to the Dow Jones Industrial Average. And in that Dow average, we have kind of an interesting situation in that several companies are being removed from the Dow average, and we've got new companies coming in. So for example, Salesforce, CRM will be replacing ExxonMobil. So you might want to look to some of these companies if you're looking for potential trades. Oftentimes, stocks will perform quite well when they find that they are going to be part of an index, and you can see CRM gapping up this morning. It'll be replacing ExxonMobil. That could actually hurt ExxonMobil. Amgen will be replacing Pfizer in the Dow, and you can see a big gap up here in Amgen this morning as a result of that. And then Honeywell will be replacing Raytheon, RTX, and you can see Honeywell gapping up substantially this morning. Now, the purpose of this is because of the decision of Apple to do their split. Apparently, Apple is going to go from a number one weighting in the average to about 17th in the average. And I guess they felt they needed to make these adjustments by the end of the month to try and balance the index a little bit better. It'll be interesting to see how these big changes will actually affect. So watch that closely. So a few news events that will move the Dow around and could be an interesting look at the market here for a while as that starts to settle and shuffle around, and all the index funds and everything having to shift their purchasing and buying in those stocks. Let's take a look at the technicals here in the chart. And the technicals in the chart, you know, guys, there's just nothing in here but bullishness. You can't see anything but bullishness in these charts. Just rampant bullishness. One has to wonder how much longer this can continue, but with the markets looking forward to Jerome Powell's speech on Thursday, where it is expected he's going to lay out a completely new policy idea for the FOMC that they are likely to hold interest rates extremely low, and they're going to take an entirely different view as their policy work when it comes to inflation, allowing inflation to rise And rather than working to control inflation, they want to see that inflation come up substantially. So an interesting shift, which means rates will stay low for a long time. Markets love that. And we could see the market continue to drive higher with that whole idea of the FOMC embracing inflation. Let's take a look at the SPY. SPY, very, very strong yesterday in its move, as you can see, pushed up substantially, closed above 3,400 for the very first time. And we're looking at just a slight move up this morning. S&P 500 isn't as energetic this morning as the Dow. So let's keep an eye on that. But we're holding in a beautiful upside trend. And even if we needed to rest or pull back, there is absolutely nothing wrong with that chart or trend at this moment. Very, very strong. If we take a look at the NASDAQ, the same thing is true. Microsoft, Apple, Google, all getting a little bit of a pullback by the end of the day yesterday, just a little tiny pullback. And we're seeing a little bit of a flatness in the NASDAQ this morning. We'll want to keep an eye on that. Just a tiny little bit of flat. Maybe even a possible little pullback here this morning. But as we continue to push this index higher and higher and higher, we're going to want to watch this trend very closely. There's nothing wrong with this chart if we pull back. If we pull back into here, no big deal. What's going to be interesting, though, is if we were to break this very, very strong trend and start breaking support levels. So until that occurs, stay with the trend. The bulls are in control. And at least at this point, there is no sign of them being willing to stop. A little pullback here in this chart will not hurt us at all. Let's take a look at IWM. IWM really kind of faltered a little bit yesterday in comparison to the other indexes. It just really didn't get going. But it's improving a little bit this morning. As you can see, we're trying to gap up a little bit into resistance in the chart. One of the things we really need to get going here is we need to see some support of oil prices. We need to see some support in those financials. And they started to get a little bit of that yesterday. So let's keep a close eye on that possibility of this pushing on higher. We need to break that resistance level right there in the chart. And if I mark that here, you can see there's a significant resistance level in IWM. We're going to need some kind of energy to push us up through there. And it's possible we could certainly get that at any time. So watch that carefully if we can break on through to that new level in IWM. Let's take a look at our VIX. The VIX, interestingly enough, even after that big push up yesterday, I was kind of hoping that we would see this break down a little bit more. But isn't it interesting that the VIX is struggling to break this little support area in the chart? That happens to be right around the 500-day moving average. We just can't seem, even with that rampant bullish yesterday, couldn't seem to get a diminishment in fear. As a matter of fact, by the end of the day, notice that fear came back in just a little bit. So we're going to want to keep a close eye on this still. It's a bit perplexing seeing new market highs and rampant bullishness and buying everywhere, but we're not seeing fear drop out of this market or that volatility. Watch that pretty closely. It could be an interesting situation if we were to pop up through there. Just keep a close eye on that. I really think to get some comfort in the market where we are right now, to get us away from showing us maybe a large complacency here with this showing so high, we really need to see that start breaking down. But so far, haven't been able to do that in the VIX. So watch that carefully. Let's take a look at T2122. T2122 is the 4-week new high, new low ratio. And with this morning's gap up in the market, I suspect we could be right up here in that bearish reversal zone this morning. So let's watch that carefully. That doesn't necessarily mean that we're going to get an immediate pullback, but we do want to watch that. If we pop up here, another gap up, more record highs in the market, that possibility of a bit of a profit-taking wave could come in and pull back at any time. So watch that carefully as we push back up here into that region. You know, one has to wonder, with the FOMC planning to do what they're going to do on inflation, all of the money being pumped into the markets from around the world, we may have to come up with a new definition of what a frothy market actually looks like. And I'm not sure we can really hold on to much right now, because it's just a relentless push by governments to push the markets up. There's no concern of debt. It's going to be an interesting situation what these new levels might look like. And although I keep pointing out things like T21-22, we could really be moving into a new metric in the market. And I'm not really sure what that's going to look at. This has been an historic run. We've never seen a rally back in history of this strength or magnitude. And we're breaking all of these records. There is a new dynamic in this market. So we're going to have to stay very focused. The reason I'm bringing that up is we need to stay very focused on the price action of the charts, because we don't want to become complacent. We don't want to forget that the bears are still out there. And if they do happen to attack, if that music stops, there could be a heavy attack coming in at some point in time. So just make sure you stay focused on the price action of the chart. Don't become overly complacent in this market. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. And our economic calendar, we've got a few things that we're going to want to pay attention to today. We have Case-Shiller housing prices, not expected to move the market around tremendously, but we'll want to be focused on that. Consumer confidence is going to be important here today to see if that consumer confidence is starting to rebound back or continue to slip. And then new home sales. We know home sales have just been incredible. As a matter of fact, builders can't seem to keep up with the rampant buying going on in homes with these low rates. So keep a close eye on that. Those could be bullish items for the market today. We also have a Fed speaker later on today. And then keep in mind, we've got durable goods orders tomorrow morning. That's one of those big numbers that can move the market around. So make sure you're thinking about that in your planning for the day ahead. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar. We have 20 plus companies reporting earnings today, and we've got a few companies that, well, more companies today that are truly notable that we'll want to keep an eye on. Let's take a look. JWN. JWN is going to be reporting, and looks like we're gapping just slightly up here on JWN. This hasn't been a stellar stock by any means, but we are making this little higher low, and if we can get a good report, this may start to recover here in Nordstrom's. If we take a look at ADSK, ADSK will be reporting. Keep an eye on ADSK. I'm not going to cover everything this morning. There are quite a few, but BBY is a notable. Looks like they're gapping down this morning on their report. BBY must have disappointed just a little bit. It's been on a tremendous run, so pullback shouldn't be a big surprise. Take a look at some of the kind of defensive sector stocks. Hormel will be reporting today. We'll want to keep an eye on that. Packaged foods, that's always an interesting place. We've got Intuit. We'll be reporting today. What a tremendous run in the last few days in anticipation of earnings. Let's watch that closely as it comes into its report. Schmuckers is reporting this morning. Looks like they're gapping up substantially. There's another one of those consumer defensive packaged food companies looking very good. So we will also hear from Toll Brothers. Looks like Toll Brothers looking for a slight gap up this morning. It's been on a tremendous run. And one more retailer Urban Outfitters will be reporting today. And wide bid-ask spread here so far this morning. Doesn't look like they have reported just yet. So keep an eye on those earnings reports. Let's take a look. Oh, and by the way, guys, if you want a complete list of those notable earnings reports at any time, if you look right below the description on this video, the title, there will be a link back to the morning blog where you can always get that information. I post that every single day, so make sure if you want to check out the complete list, you can go to the morning blog. Let's take a look at some stocks that could be setting up. But before we do that, if you guys could do me a favor, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that bell or that subscribe button on YouTube, become a subscriber to the channel, support the channel. We have a lot of folks that watch these videos that I think haven't subscribed. So if you could do that, it certainly helps out a lot. And I truly, truly appreciate it. And also click that bell icon when it pops up so that you can be notified every time I post a video. You know, I've gone through a little bit of a health, just a little bit of illness situation, and so I haven't been posting a lot of videos, but there's several new videos that will be posted to YouTube here before too long. So training videos, so make sure you've clicked that notification so you can get those as soon as they get posted. Also, if this is a useful video to you, please click that thumbs up button and leave a brief comment. I truly, truly appreciate it. It helps us continue to grow the channel. You guys are awesome. So let's take a look at a few stocks that are setting up. Remember, every time I post a stock in these videos, it's not a recommendation to buy or sell any security. Make sure you do your own due diligence in these charts. Boy, I got to tell you, one chart that really was pretty impressive yesterday was General Motors. General Motors really popping hard yesterday. If we take a look at this, you can see we have this nice little upside trend. We're holding in here on some price support, and we had that nice little pop-up yesterday, kind of a Morningstar type pattern bullishness coming into General Motors. Now, General Motors still has a lot of work to do. I don't want to give you the impression that it's free and clear to the upside. There's significant resistance up here, but GM's starting to improve dramatically. You might want to take a look at that, put it on a list, mark it up, maybe potentially wait for that next trade. Take a look at STZ. Constellation Brands made a nice little move yesterday, pushing up, and you can see we have an interesting little pattern here with a little rise. We broke above some support, we held that support, and buyer stepping in here. So we'll want to watch these additional resistance levels in the chart. This is one of those consumer defensive companies, but STZ looking pretty good, might be a potential trade, something you might want to keep an eye on. Overall, just looking pretty good. If we take a look, Disney had a nice rebound yesterday. Now, I'm a holder of Disney, so I want to let you guys know that I could have a bias on this trade. But when I take a look at this chart, this is a really nice potential move to the upside here. And we're holding this price support in the chart. Now, clearly we have price resistance above that we still have to deal with, so we're not out of the woods on this yet. But Disney's starting to come around. This may be one of those rebound companies that's a little bit slow in recovering completely, but let's keep an eye on that. Disney looking good overall. I mentioned the financials. Let's take a look at some of the financials, like JP Morgan. JP Morgan had a good day yesterday, rallying up pretty nice, and as you can see, still has some resistance to deal with, but we found that trend, we found some price support, and we can see that we're moving higher this morning, getting a little bit of more bullishness in here. We're really going to need these financials to come along and get moving, and it's nice to see them starting to perk up. So take a look at JP Morgan. You might want to take a look at BAC. BAC holding up quite well, as you can see in here, finding that support, finding buyers in here coming in. Keep an eye on those. Or even take a look at XLF. Now, XLF is what I hold. I just wanted to hold a basket of this for a longer term trade. And I really like that pattern there in XLF, holding that support, bulls stepping in and now following through this morning. So keep a close eye on that. I also mentioned some of the energy sector. Take a look at XLE. Now, XLE has had a pretty bad run here the last couple of weeks, as you can see, pushing down. But all of a sudden, it popped up yesterday. Now, energy has a resistance area up here that we're going to have to be watchful of. We could rally back up into that level, turn right around, and go back south. So watch that carefully. But if we are going to start seeing things reopening, those kind of things, people starting to do a little bit more travel, we might see energy starting to pick back up. And I have the firm belief that oil will not stay this cheap forever. And so I'm going to be holding some of this. Take a look at SLB, Schlumberger. SLB had a really big bounce back yesterday. Once again, it's challenged by some resistance in the chart that we're going to have to watch pretty carefully. But if that can break on through that level, then we have that opportunity for this to pop on through and hold that support and start moving on up. So keep an eye on some of those energy companies. You're also going to want to keep an eye on some of the big techs. And I'm going to be talking about the possibility of pullbacks or failures. We have Microsoft up here banging its head against resistance and struggling up here. We're going to want to watch this pretty closely. If Microsoft can't break through there, we want to watch for that possible failure starting to come in. Now, I'm not suggesting this is just going to fall out of bed and turn into a terrible trade, but that possibility that it could pull back and go into a longer rest after such a tremendous rally back. Keep a close eye on that. For those of you who are option traders, this might set up as a little bit of a speculation trade, but maybe a bear call credit spread, get up above this price and see if that just rests or pulls back in here. Watch that closely. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great profits. Once again, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, please make sure and click that subscribe button. Thanks to everyone who does take the time to click those thumbs ups and leave a comment. I truly, truly appreciate it. Y'all take care. Have an awesome day. Stay safe. We'll see you right back here bright and early Wednesday morning. Take care.